We all know about planning in an education institution or any corporate world. The importance of planning is known by each and everybody. But before that, what is the meaning of planning? Planning refers to a systematic arrangement of things so that it can be implemented in a proper way to achieve the set. So why should we plan? So that is called as importance of planning. It ensures success of the institution. Definitely, it eliminates trial and error pattern. It reduces chances of failure. So any kind of loss or failure is overcome if you plan very systematically and very sincere. When you plan any kind of activities in your institution, say an educational institution, it is reduces the waste. It also reduces the wastage and in terms of resources. So it provides intelligent directions to activity. Yes, any activity which has to be performed will have a blueprint in front of them through which we can achieve the set goals. It also helps to use the resources available in an institution. The resources are of two types. As we know, they are man-made as well as your physical resources. So any resources, if it has to be tapped and used by an institution in a proper way, it needs severe planning. So planning, when it is done by an education institution, all the manpower is being used to the optimum. That is, nobody is left out, nor nobody is burdened with an extra work. Similarly, physical resources can also be used. For example, in an education institution, if we have different rooms for our methods, for different subjects, each rooms can be used not only for subjects, but they can be also used for conducting some kind of an activity for all the students. Similarly, if we have to arrange certain visiting or guest faculty lecture also, we could accommodate them in a specific room which has been designed by us. So it avoids wastage and stagnation. So it also improves the competitive strength of the institution. Yes, all the persons in the institution knows that they have to achieve the set goal. So it brings in a uniform efforts towards the achieving the set goal. It also, of course, saves time, effort and money. It avoids duplication of efforts. Yes. For example, if a person is assigned a task of teaching a subject in an education institution, another person may not be given the responsibility of teaching the same subject. For example, a teacher who has the specialized subject as, say, social sciences, there we have history as well as geography teacher. So a history teacher, if she is giving certain, is being given certain portion for teaching, she can deal with that if she is systematically planning her lecture. So the same matter need not be taught by a geography teacher, though they both of them belong to a social science. So planning helps us to avoid duplication of efforts. Last but not the least, it is a coordinated means of attaining predetermined purposes. The set goal, if it has to be achieved, needs to be planned in a systematic way right from the beginning. The first step to achieve success is planning. So when you plan systematically, you follow those steps and achieve the set goal without much efforts and without much wastage. Thank you. One of the important functions of management is staffing. Staffing is nothing but recruiting the right person for the right job, at the right time and at the right place. One of the definition of Coutts and O'Donnell says that staffing pertains to recruitment, selection, development and compensation of subordinates. It is a managerial function of staffing involves manning the organizational structure through proper and effective selection, appraisal and development of personnel to fill the roles designed under the structure. So we could see that selection, appraisal and development, these are the three components of staffing. We not only have to, the education institution or any other corporate world, not only have to develop, select the staff for the institution, they also have to appraise, that is performance appraisal, and develop the role of the personnel in the organization. So the components of staffing involves the following. First is manpower planning. Manpower planning is selecting the persons according to his qualifications, abilities, at the right place, at the right time, and for the right purpose. Only if this is done, will the management or the educational institution will be using their resources to the optimum. Second, staffing also involves recruitment, selection, and placement. Advertising for the vacancy in an institution, it starts. When I say staffing, it includes recruitment, that is advertising through papers and inviting the applicants for the job, and then selecting according to their qualification, experience, and placing it at the right place. Thirdly, it also involves training and development. If the staff is not given proper training at the right time, they may not develop. They may become stagnant at the same place. So when I say staffing, it involves training and developing the role, that is giving some opportunities for the staff to move on, to promote. Next is remuneration. Yes, staffing also involves fixing the proper remuneration according to the capacities, abilities, qualifications which demand for the job for which the person has applied. Performance appraisal has to be done of the staff regularly or at the end of 6 months or in a year or monthly, depending on the kind of institution, so that the staff knows to what extent have they contributed to the institution. Last but not the least, promotion and transfer. Yes, if a candidate has achieved his targets, he has to be promoted to the next thing. And then if he has to be transferred to some other place for learning more things, then that has to be also taken care of by the HR. So an education institution requires such a staff so that they can do their maximum work at the minimum cost and contribute to the welfare of the organization. So all these components together, we call it as staffing. And staffing is one of the important functions of the educational management. Thank you for watching my YouTube video. Keep watching my YouTube channel for updates. Thank you, friends. Thank you so much.